click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture basically we are going to talk about the hydrogen bonding, and in the overall chapter we have talked about various kind of the bonds that we have got to know, that is sigma bond, pi bond, and how they have been formed and what is the mechanism behind that and what is the reason behind that they have been forming a pi bond or a sigma bond. So now we are going to talk about a special kind of bond, and that is known as hydrogen bonding. So what is this hydrogen bonding and what are its types? Let us talk about it. So talking about the hydrogen bonding is not a kind of bond that is just like that of a sigma bond or a pi bond. Actually, it is a kind of special kind of bond that takes place between the two molecules, and the molecules which has basically electronegativity difference. And that is how the electronegativity, because of the electronegativity difference, this is a kind of attraction that takes place between the two molecules. And that is what we could say, that the hydrogen plays a very vital role in this attraction. How? Let us talk about it with the help of the definition first. So according to hydrogen bonding, that we know that is hydrogen bond can be defined as the attractive force which binds hydrogen atom of a molecule with that of the electronegative atom of the another molecule. So this is a kind of special kind of bonding that I am going to talk about with the help of an example. Suppose if I am talking about molecule like HF. So this is the molecule that we know, and we know that this is basically forming a covalent bond. So the hydrogen and the fluorine, they will have a covalent bond between them, and the reason behind that is because of the overlapping of the orbitals that we have learned in our previous lecture. But this is a special kind of bond that we know is as polar covalent bond. So the reason behind this is polar because hydrogen is more electropositive, while talking about the fluorine is more electronegative in the whole periodic table that we know. So making this to be having a partially negative charge on towards the fluorine, and that is the partially positive charge on that of the hydrogen atom. So this is because the fluorine has the capacity to attack the shared pair of electrons towards itself, and that is the reason that the fluorine is more electronegative compared to whenever the bond has been formed between these two atoms. And talking about the hydrogen atom, hydrogen has the capacity to lose electrons, and even though the bonding is basically covalent, but because of the electronegativity of the fluorine, we could see this kind of behavior. And making this kind of bond is known as polar covalent bond. But this is what we have talked about only in one molecule. And regarding that, we have talked about the atoms also. But what if this molecule has been surrounded by various molecules like HF or like of any molecule? Suppose if I'm talking about HF only, suppose this HF is being surrounded by that of another molecule, that is HF, in this way. Again, we could say that the fluorine will have basically partially negative charge, while that of the hydrogen will have partially positive charge. So whenever these two molecules are close to each other, we could see that they will orient themselves in such a way that the negative part of the fluorine, it will try to attack toward that of the positive part of the other molecule, that is hydrogen. So this is because of, we know that the opposite charge attract each other, and that is the reason that a kind of force of attraction, it will be there between these two molecules, and because of which we know that the other molecule, it consists of hydrogen atom. And that's the reason that the hydrogen bond and that's the reason that the hydrogen consists of partially positive charge, and the fluorine atom of this one consists of partially negative charge. So that will be kind of force of attraction between these two. So this kind of force of attraction between a hydrogen atom of another molecule and fluorine atom of this molecule, so this kind of force of attraction is known as basically hydrogen bonding. So this is what I call it as hydrogen bond. So this is not a sigma bond, this is not a pi bond, this is the kind of force of attraction, and that's the reason it's called as hydrogen bond, and this is what I was talking about. So hydrogen bond is not, can be observed in any molecule. For example, if I would say like methane, so if I'm talking about methane, in this manner, I suppose if that methane is surrounded by another methane molecule like this one, suppose if I'm talking about this one. So as the hydrogen bond has been present over here, that is between carbon and hydrogen, and the hydrogen atom is present in the other that is molecule, that is methane, but we can't say that there will be a kind of attraction over here. The reason behind that is, suppose if we consider the hydrogen to be partially positive for this one, and even this is partially positive, so they won't have an attraction toward this one. Because of, we know that the methane molecule consists of the carbon atom which has not too much of electronegativity difference, and that's the reason that one of the methane molecule will not have an attraction towards the another of the methane molecule, and that is how we can't find hydrogen bonding over here. So Yes, that's the reason that we have talked about that the hydrogen bonding depends on the electronegativity of a particular atom. And in this methane, the carbon and the hydrogen, they don't have that much of electronegativity difference. So obviously they won't have a kind of partially positive charge or partially negative charge on them. And if they don't have this kind of partially positive charge, and if they don't have this kind of partially positive or negative charge, so how could we could say that that molecule is basically polar? So basically this is a non-polar molecule, and the other molecule that has been attached over here is also a non-polar molecule, and we could say that the hydrogen bonding has not been observed over here. So the hydrogen bonding is not only been observed in the similar molecules which have the electronegativity, it can also be observed in the other molecules also. Suppose if HF has been surrounded with that of a methane molecule, suppose the similarity that I have mentioned over here. So this is a very different thing that I was talking about, and let me talk about this one. So fluorine, as we know, that is it is partially negative charge and it is more electronegative. So it will have a shared pair of electrons to itself and making the fluorine to be having a partially negative charge. Suppose if it tries to, it is surrounded with that of a methane molecule and that is basically non-polar. So in this case, basically the hydrogen, it will turn into a partially positive charge because the fluorine will have an attraction towards the hydrogen, and that is the reason that the carbon in this case will have partially negative charge, and this is how we could find the hydrogen bonding here also. So it is not necessary that the two same similar molecules they will have a hydrogen bonding, even the two different molecules, but having a possibility of electronegativity difference, and that also they could find and have a hydrogen bonding. So this is what I was talking about. So this is a very simple topic that I was talking about, and yes, the main thing is electronegativity. But now, the hydrogen bonding are of two types. So this is the thing that I'm talking about. And let me talk about, there are basically two types of hydrogen bonding. So the first one is, intermolecular hydrogen bond, and the second one is, so these are the types of hydrogen bond that I'm going to talk about. So I will talk about the first one, that is intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So intermolecular hydrogen bonding is very simple to understand. That is, it is a kind of the hydrogen bonding that takes place between the two different molecules or the two same molecules, but not within the same molecule. So let me give an example. So this was an example that I was talking about. That is, so this was an example where the two different molecules, they are basically the same molecules, but talking about this thing, that the hydrogen bonding is formed between two molecules, and that is what we could see over here. They could be same also, they could be different also. So this kind of bonding that takes place between the two same or between the two different molecules, they are known as basically intermolecular hydrogen bonding, and that is what we could observe over here. So they have certain effects on it, and let me tell you about that also. So this kind of intermolecular hydrogen bonding that we could observe in molecules such as HF, or such as, if I would mention about this thing, that is H2O. So this is not the actual geometry that I am representing over here. Suppose, just for an instant, suppose if I am representing in this way. So this is for the H2O molecule. Similarly, we could also represent for nitrogen also. So this is what I am representing for the ammonia, which consists of nitrogen that is more electronegative. And that is what I am representing over here. Suppose this is what I am representing. So if you observe this two, so these two have basically, we know that oxygen is more electronegative, while that of the hydrogen is more electropositive. So this will go on, and you could find that these two different, or these two molecules will have a force of attraction between them because of the electronegativity of oxygen and hydrogen. And that is how we could find that is hydrogen bonding. But this hydrogen bonding is between the two molecules, and that's the reason it is known as intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So similarly here also, the nitrogen is more electronegative and the hydrogen is more electropositive, and we could find basically the force of attraction between these two, and again this is a kind of intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So this is what intermolecular hydrogen bonding is. And let me talk about the effect of, and what and how does it play a very important role in boiling point, melting point, or physical constant. So talking about the hydrogen bonding and talking about the boiling point and melting point, or such kind of property or solubility. hydrogen bonding is responsible for increase in the boiling point. Yes, and that's the reason that water molecule, that is, it has an appreciable, that is, a boiling point that is 100 degrees Celsius that we know. But usually, it is because of the hydrogen bonding that it creates between the two molecules. And similarly, if we talk about ammonia also, so ammonia is basically will have a particular boiling point if we talk about the bond energy between the nitrogen and hydrogen. But it has been observed that the boiling point of not only water, not only ammonia, but of HF also, it is appreciably higher. The reason behind that is the force, extra force of attraction that it plays between these two molecules. So it is not only the one molecule that it has, but it can be surrounded by various water molecules also. And that's the reason that more energy is being required to break the bond and or this kind of interaction. And that's the reason the boiling point increases. And we see an expected boiling point, which is comparatively high if we talk about the bond energy between the atoms like oxygen and that is hydrogen. So that's the reason that HF, ammonia, H2, they have appreciable high boiling point compared to other molecules. So if you talk about methane is very, it doesn't require any kind of higher boiling point because obviously we know that it is not forming a hydrogen bond, and that's the reason that the boiling point of the methane is very much less compared to that of the H2. So it depends on the polarity also, as well as it depends on the hydrogen bonding. So there are various factors. So therefore, intermolecular hydrogen bonding, it increases the boiling point, it increases the we could say the solubility and all. So there are the reason that we are talking about in this manner. So now let us talk about the second one that I was talking about, and the second one is basically intramolecular. So this is the kind of hydrogen bonding that takes place within the molecule. Let me give you an example. So this is an example that I am talking about, and the name of this one is basically known as orthonitrophenol. And if you observe this one, then here also we could find hydrogen bonding. How? To have an hydrogen bonding, at least one of the molecules should have hydrogen. And that is the main criteria for that. So in this molecule also, if you observe that this is the hydrogen atom that we have, and obviously that is because of the oxygen that is magnetized, so therefore this is partially positive, while this oxygen is partially negative. So therefore there will be kind of force of attraction between these two. And this kind of attraction that we observe here, it is taking place within the molecule itself, and that's the reason that this is kind of hydrogen bonding, and that is especially known as intramolecular hydrogen bonding, and that's what we observe here. So this is the molecule that I was talking about as an example, and we could talk about the other examples also. And so similarly, this is the one that has been responsible for that is intermolecular hydrogen bonding, and we could see that the property of this one is comparatively different compared to that of the intermolecular hydrogen bonding, because in the previous one that we have got to know that the boiling point of such kind of the molecules that exhibit intermolecular force of attraction or intermolecular hydrogen bonding, they have higher boiling point, they have higher melting point, solubility also, and that goes on. But this, in this case, it is opposite. The reason behind that is because the hydrogen bonding that takes place within the molecule, so that's the reason that there would be no force of attraction that takes place with the other molecule. And that's the reason that the two molecules, suppose if another molecule has been attached over here, or it has been surrounded with another molecule like that of the other O-nitrophenol, so there won't be force of attraction between these two because of the hydrogen bonding or because of the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. And that's the reason that the boiling point of this is comparatively expected to be low, and that is what we are talking about. And there are also various criteria like solubility also. So this won't be that much because it won't be interacting with of the other molecules in which it has been dissolved, like suppose if water. So therefore there will be no higher solubility if you observe this thing, and that have different properties. So these were the two examples that I was talking about, that is intermolecular and intramolecular hydrogen bonding. And that's it, that is what I want to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know that is what is hydrogen bonding and what are the types of hydrogen bonding with the help of this example also. So I hope you will share this video with friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.